أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وبعد. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Respected المشايخ, my brothers, sisters, I was hiding so well, it didn't work. For some reason Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts me in front of you, in front of people to talk. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make my inner better than what you think of me. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive my past and future and make me better inshallah in His sight. To talk about awliyaullah is one thing. For me to talk about awliyaullah is something completely different. You're wasting your time. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to receive at least one in our lifetime a nazar of the wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That will be enough for our salvation inshaAllah ta'ala, to be in the path of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There is no wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who is actually, technically speaking, all the karamats, all the wondrous acts of the awliyaullah is nothing more than the extension of the mu'jizat of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There is no wali who is a wali, true wali, who is not directly connected to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Regardless of how we think, how we feel, every wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a true representative of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There are the ulama of Zahir who know the outer sciences. MashaAllah, we need them. But true wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is also the doctor of the inner. Imam al-Ghazali rahmahullah, when he defines an alim, he says every alim will have five qualities. First, every alim is an abid. There is tahajjud in their lives. There is unsurpassed ibadah in their lives, the connectedness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you go at 2 o'clock in the morning, they will not be on the internet doing research on certain websites, but they will be with their Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Their second quality, they will have ilm of zahir, all the sharia sciences under their belt, whatever the sharia approves, from fiqh, from aqaid, from seerah, from whatever, tafsir. Thirdly, they will have the knowledge of the inner. They went through the tazkiyah process themselves and purified their inner, and they have the ability to rectify your inner. Rectify your inner. When you are in contact with them, they will take you by the hand. Regardless of your diseases, they will take you by the hand. And bi'idhnillahi ta'ala, by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's permission, will correct you, bring you back to the fold of the path of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he says the last quality of an alim, he does everything li wajhillah, only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then what is quite concerning to us, Imam Ghazali then says, in our time, the real ulama is gone. No more. We have lots of zahiri ulama who are learning the deen to rub shoulders with the politicians, to become leaders in the community. But the true ulama, and he gives the examples of the four imams, Abu Hanifa, rahimahullah, Imam Shafi'i, rahimahullah, إمام مالك رحمه الله، إمام أحمد بن حنبل رحمه الله، السفيان الثوري رحمه الله، all of them he mentions. These were the true ulama. These were the true wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of our favorite pastimes amongst us is talk about the karamat of awliyaullah, which is good, because when the awliyaullah mentioned, the barakah descends upon the people. Not a problem. But this should not be just a pastime, favorite pastime for us. Unless you look at their lives and base your lifestyle and follow the footsteps of such great awliyaullah, it means nothing. Just a folkloric telltales amongst people. It will not bring any benefit to you. Even if your great, 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 great father was somebody else. So wali of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why did I say this? Because I personally heard this from my Shaykh, Mahmud Asajushan, Qaddasallahu Sirrahu al-Aziz. He was narrating from one of the great tabi'een. Great tabi'een. He mentioned his name, but I can't remember his name. He said it was in the middle of the night. I was next to Hajar al-Aswad. And in my ibadat, I saw somebody holding his hand to the door of Kaaba and that special corner in that multazam, making dua. So beautiful. He says, I could not help myself but to listen. Well, no, he was not shouting with adab, with tears. And few moments onwards, I understood that this person was a Sayyid. One of the great, great children of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, from that Ahlul Bayt. He says, when I finished my salat and ibadah, I waited. And he finished his dua. And I hugged him. I kissed him. And he said, I said to him, why are you worried? Your great-grandfather is Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Why are you worried? Why are you making so ardent dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? He turned around and said, after knowing who I was, he says, don't you know, we will stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. If I don't have fear Allah, if I don't have taqwa, if I don't practice the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what is my chances that to receive that ownership from Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, saying that this fasiq is also one of me? I need to make that effort. Yes, there are cases where Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will come to your help. No problem. But the reality is, we need to walk the walk. Yes, do the talk at the same time. But we need to do our bit of teaching our children the muhabba of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, muhabba of Quran, love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our deen, our sharia, our fiqh, our way of life. Then we have to show as an example to our families and to our neighbors. We have to practice the deen, accept everybody for the sake of la ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah as our brethren in our deen. Then we can hope, we can sit in the majalis of mawlid, and we can sit in the majlis where we remember the greatest Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani, Qaddasallahu Sirrahu al-Aziz. Then we can feel the arwah amongst us. Otherwise, if this place is filled with people who do not have anything to show in their business lives, in their family lives, in their school lives, with their practices and mu'amalat amongst people, they live like non-Muslims, but comes at night, they put the topi on, the galabiyya on, and stand in front of people and deliver a talk like me on awliyaullah, we have long way to go. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive me for being a little bit harsh on you. But this sometimes has to be said. Because the Shaykh or Mashaykh gave so much hope to you. Hope is good, but it has to be brought some balance. Inna akramakum indallahi atqakum. This is our criteria. Ilahi anta maqsoodi wa rudaka matloobi. In everything I do, Ya Rabbil Alameen, anta maqsoodi. My goal is you. What I seek is your rida. رضا of Allah سبحانه وتعالى is only in the اتباع, in the love, محبة of Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم, his part. And the part of those أولياء الله, علماء المحققين, أولياء المقربين, أهل السنة والجماعة, straight part. May Allah سبحانه وتعالى include us, our children, our loved ones in that path of that beautiful path of Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين لله تعالى الفاتح. جزاكم الله خير.
الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على أكمل الأشرفين على سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا وكبيرنا.